The second mechanism that will induce air to rise, I realize it took a lot to get to this point, is called cyclonic lifting. Cyclonic lifting occurs when air is forced to rise in a low pressure system. Remember, cyclone is low pressure. If you take a look at this diagram, you can see that with low pressure, the air converges and rises. As we know, as the air is rising, it's cooling, relative humidity is going up, and a cloud can form. If we were going to put the math on this, here's what it would look like. From the ground up to the bottom of the cloud, we would use the DAR. The bottom of the cloud represents the condensation level. And so from the bottom of the cloud up to the top of the cloud, if we were calculating temperature change, we would use the WAR. See how quick that one was? Now we have convectional lifting. This is when air is forced to rise as a result of surface heating. As you see with the diagram, what will happen is this. The ground during the day, because of absorption of shortwave radiation, will begin to get hot. The air in contact, because the air takes on the characteristics of what it's over, will also get hot. What does hot air do? Hot air rises. So that air is rising because it's in contact with a warm ground surface. Again, if we were going to place the math on this, from the ground up to the bottom of the cloud is the condensation level, we would use the DAR because the relative humidity is less than 100%. However, once the cloud begins to form from the bottom of the cloud, the condensation level to the top of the cloud, it would be 100% relative humidity, and we would use the WAR to calculate the temperature change in that vertically moving parcel of air. On that same trip I was on in Hawaii I flew from the Big Island of Hawaii to Oahu. And as you do that, you fly past Maui and Molokai and whatever the other one is. And as I was flying, it was probably 1 or 2 o'clock in the afternoon, I looked out and I noticed the clouds were forming over the top of the islands, but not over the top of the ocean. Because the ocean's temperature doesn't change radically from day to night, but the land does. So when the sun comes up, the land gets heated, that hot air begins to rise, and then that makes clouds, especially in that very wet environment of Hawaii. And so you can see over the top of the island, you can see very clearly where the islands are, there's clouds. It's remarkable. That's convectional lifting.